Tonight, the Stig drives some very fast farm equipment, I hail a taxi, and finishing with something that I'm reliably informed is a bit of a fan favourite around here. I'm Chris Harris, and this is the Top Gear Horizon Special. Yes, the Stig, our very own UFO, unidentified fast object, the world's least obedient racing driver. Hang on a minute. Sideways now, making it look easy too. Yes, that's it, the honorable art of drifting. It's not the fastest way around a corner, but it's definitely the most entertaining. Well, they did say to use the fastest route possible, and if there's one thing faster than a racing line, it's a straight line. You've got to hand it to the Stig. Made it! Was there ever any doubt? The Series 1 Elise is, after all, one of the best handling cars ever made. The Sport 190 is its hardcore cousin, a road-going racer you can drive to work and across fields, it turns out. But if it's true agricultural transport you're after, we have just the thing. This is Project EAT. That's EAT for E-Class All Terrain. It's a modified Merc built by the Top Gear magazine team for finding bears in the woods. Not many bears around here, though. Mostly badgers. Still, there's definitely some terrain. Lots of it. All you need is a good sense of direction. Or not. Here's Stig again, looking lost. Terrified of maps, apparently. Inner compass points directly south. The EAT has a silky smooth V6 diesel. It'll do 155 miles an hour on the road, but where we're going, we won't need roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rath. By any means necessary, and against the clock, naturally. But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres, and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres.
In 400 yards, turn left. Turn left.
That's some proper hang time! Actual air suspension! Who says you need an SUV to go off-road? The EAT has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps and everyday obstacles. Ancient burial mounds, for example.
Yards. Turn sharp left. Turn sharp left.
Well, it is a Mercedes wagon, so it's tough. And if you really want to smash stuff up, there's even a pickaxe in the back.
In 400 yards, turn sharp left.
It also has 340 horsepower, more torque than a cruise ship, and gets to 60 miles an hour in just over 5 seconds. Time to head way over there to the... goes up, must come down.
In 400 yards, turn left. right. In 400 yards, turn left. Turn left.
That's a four-wheel drive car on mud tyres completely sideways. You'd do well in rallying with skills like that. Top draw drifting, I reckon. It's full of home comforts, the EAT. Charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting, even a portable espresso machine. Everything the Intrepid Explorer can ever need.
At the roundabout, take the first exit. In 400 yards, turn right. Turn right.
All right, all this adventure kit's had a tiny effect on the fuel efficiency. Good job the roof rack holds. Two cans of diesel, and there's another one in the back. Just don't confuse them. You're drinking water.
In 100 yards, turn right.
The EAT has a silky smooth V6 diesel. It'll do 155 miles an hour on the road, but where we're going, we won't need roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rannoch by any means necessary and against the clock, naturally. But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres.
In 400 yards...
Says you need an SUV to go off-road. The EAT has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps and everyday obstacles. Ancient burial mounds, for example.
Recalculating route. In 200 yards, turn right. In 200 yards, turn right. In 200 yards, turn left.
Some proper hang time. Actual air suspension.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Well, it is a Mercedes wagon, so it's tough. And if you really want to smash stuff up, there's even a pickaxe in the back.
In 400 yards, turn right.
It also has 340 horsepower, more torque than a cruise ship, and gets to 60 miles an hour in just over 5 seconds. Time to head way over there, to the very top of Arthur's Seat. But first, what goes up must come down.
Around when it is safe to do so.
Watch out here. I bet nobody checked the train timetable. Does anybody check train timetables anymore?
Recalculating route.
It's full of home comforts, the EAT. Charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting. Even a portable espresso machine. Everything the Intrepid Explorer could ever need.
At the roundabout, take the first exit. In 400 yards, turn right. turn right.
All right, all this adventure kit's had a tiny effect on the fuel efficiency. Good job the roof rack holds two cans of diesel, and there's another one in the back. Just don't confuse them with your drinking water. That's a four-wheel drive car on mud tyres, completely sideways. You'd do well in rally. With skills like that, top draw drifting, I reckon. Onto the final stretch now. Just the small matter of getting up Arthur's seat. The clock's ticking, so better step on it, Stiggy. The EAT has a silky smooth V6. Diesel. It'll do 155 miles an hour on the road, but where we're going, we won't need roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rannoch by any means necessary and against the clock, naturally. But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres.
In 200 yards, turn left. Turn left. In 200 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Who says you need an SUV to go off-road? EAT has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps and everyday obstacles. Ancient burial mounds, for example. Well, it is a Mercedes wagon, so it's tough. And if you really want to smash stuff up, there's even a pickaxe in the back.
In 200 yards, turn sharp left. Recalculating route.
That's some proper hang time. Actual air suspension.
In 200 yards, turn sharp left.
It also has 340 horsepower, more torque than a cruise ship, and gets to 60 miles an hour in just over 5 seconds. perfect time to head way over there, to the very top of Arthur's Seat. But first, what goes up must come down.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
It's full of home comforts, the EAT. Charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting, even a portable espresso machine. Everything the intrepid explorer could ever need.
At the roundabout, take the first exit. In 400 yards, turn right. Turn right.
All right. All this adventure kit's had a tiny effect on the fuel efficiency. Good job the roof rack holds two cans of diesel, and there's another one in the back. Just don't confuse them with your drinking water.
Exit.
On to the final stretch now. Just a small matter of getting up Arthur's Seat. The clock's ticking, so better step on it, Stiggy.
At the roundabout, take the first exit.
On to the final stretch now. Just a small matter of getting up Arthur's Seat. The clock's ticking, so better step on it, Stiggy.
In 100 yards, turn left.
And there we go. The top of Arthur's Seat. No idea who Arthur is, by the way, or why his seat's so big. Nice view, though. Shame there's no time to stick around.